out with Queen, Paul and my G. Paul.
I'm Megan O'Levy, and this is your UFC Minute. This weekend, we brace for a crucial matchup, which is expected to shake up an entire division. To get into position for a world title shot, this fighter has fought tooth and nail against the best the light heavyweight division has to offer. And while getting into a number one contender's match is sweet enough, if this fighter beats his heated rival to earn that shot at the belt, the victory would be even more satisfying. That's it for today. Stay tuned for your next UFC Minute, and I'll see you at the fights.
All right, coming up next, it's a UFC light heavyweight division collision. All right, so here he is, ladies and gentlemen. He has a lot of fan support in this building here tonight. There is no denying the backdrop to this one. This is very much a rivalry fight. Both fighters have said they'll try to keep the emotions out of it. Easier said than done when there is this type of legitimate venom and bad blood.
This guy has one of the best abilities to take a shot that I have ever seen in all my years of commentating on fights. His chin is truly world class.
All right, so here he is, Corey Overtime Anderson. He has been an outstanding takedown artist in the UFC, and that really speaks to his wrestling background, Joe Rogan. Graduate of the University of Wisconsin-Whitewater, two-time collegiate wrestling All-American. He's had a lot of seminal moments in the UFC, but really believes his best days are yet to come. Corey Overtime Anderson finds himself in another massive spot tonight.
This guy has devastating one-punch knockout power, amongst the very best in the world at delivering a single blow to end the fight.
Tail of the tape for this light heavyweight tilt. Anderson is 3 years his senior. He is 1 inch taller. He will have a 3-inch reach advantage. And now to get us started, here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC.
Are you ready? You ready?
Fight. Here we go. All right, so here we go. Round one is underway of this rivalry fight here tonight. Perhaps there will be a little bit of a feeling out process here. Both guys were trying to put the emotions out of the equation here tonight. But it is rival versus rival under the lights here tonight.
In half guard.
All right, first round is underway, and I don't have to tell the avid fans, you gotta watch out for this fighter's powerful overhand punches. He does not discriminate, power from both sides, and a big part of his game plan obviously coming in here tonight.
Just missed with that huge kick.
Hard shots landing on both sides here.
Nice leg kick. Good defense there. Yeah, here he goes again.
Anderson gets the single leg takedown. Nicely done there. That one appeared to stun him.
He's trying to hang on. Oh, he missed that kick. Nice leg kick. Oh, big left.
Well, Joe, I know he respects the power coming back, but it looked like he moved right into that kick to the body, and his opponent landed it flush. So let's see if he changes up his footwork a little bit and tries to avoid further damage to the midsection moving forward. And he switches his stance yet again. How about that submission. Anderson gets caught by the inside leg kick.
Look at that nasty jab.
Joe stance switch once again. 2 minutes to go in round one. Slipped him with the jab. Oh, good job defensively to block the strike there by Anderson.
Just missed with a huge kick.
All right, so there's a swing and a miss from him, and sometimes when you miss, it can tax your gas tank even more than when you land a strike. So, wow! He's got him hurt here. Big body shot.
Body.
Oh, he slams his opponent down.
Excellent movement here on the ground.
And they separate.
Left kick to the body.
Nice defense there. Huge block.
Big punches. Huge uppercut misses. He's down.
Working out of that southpaw stance. Oh, and again, he lands another takedown there, Joe. So really doing a nice job scoring points, and the takedowns are piling up. And he's not telegraphing his shot, and that's why he's been so successful. The opponent can't see it coming.
Exactly.
That horn sounds means we have reached the end of round one.
Here's a vicious kick that results in a knockdown.
There it is again.
Let's see it one more time.
Ariane Celeste with us tonight.
Are you ready? Are you ready?
All right, second round underway.
He's definitely going to want to start this round off fast to try to pick up where he left off. His opponent was in big trouble at the end of that round.
Well, Joe, he seems to have his opponent's timing down. He has landed some good shots, but... Oh!
He's trying to stay
out. Oh, he might be out.
Big kick, but miss.
So he lands another takedown here, and that has really been the narrative in this fight, Joe Rogan. Takedowns in bunches, scoring a lot of points, and even when his opponent gets back to his feet, doesn't stay there for very long. And there comes the separation now. So the takedowns have come in bunches here tonight. Look for him to try to set up yet another one here. He'll find that window, barge right through the legs, and get his opponent to the canvas. And the kick lands. Trying to hammer that lead. Looked like it did stun him a little bit.
That hurt him.
And we have passed the midpoint of the fight.
Caught him with a punch. He secures full mount. Excellent movement and transitions here on the ground. Staying busy. Reversal here. Nicely done.
Oh, a massive elbow from the top. Under 90 seconds to go here in the second round.
Really threw everything into that uppercut, but fell short.
Man, as he landed a high volume of strikes here in round two, definitely picking up the pace after round one. So he got the message from the corner, and now he is taking control of this second round. Anderson gets hit.
Oh, clipped him again. He's hurt. He's hurt. He's hanging.
Busy as as he looks to improve position here.
While mounted here, he's got to control his opponent's posture. Hip escape, and he's out of the full mount. Nicely done. Big body punch.
10 seconds remain in round two.
Excellent punch.
And that's the end of round number two.
Let's take another look at some of the action from that round. And here's a big strike to the head that stuns. And here's another devastating shot to the head that really does damage. And here's another shot to the head that really stuns. Some serious damage landed in that round.
I need more takedown. I want you to win this fight with getting that takedown, securing it.
Jenny Andrade to get us going. Here we go. 5 minutes remain in the fight.
He's in big, big, big trouble. He hurt him with that hook.
Oh!
Oh! He tagged him again. He's out. He's out cold. To do that to such a durable guy, and to do it with such composure, the way he recognized he had him hurt, relaxed, kept his rhythm, and just dropped bombs, and then boom.
Yeah, Joe, safe to say he wasn't stalling or looking for a referee stand-up. He was looking to pound his opponent's head through the canvas, and he nearly did so with some of those hammer fists, man. He wasn't trying to score. He was trying to put an exclamation point on a most dominant performance here tonight, and he certainly did that as he ends the fight by knockout. And there he is after the huge knockout turned in tonight. Near perfect execution and one of the bigger highlights of his UFC career.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Eve Levine has called a stop to this contest at 25 seconds of round number three. Declaring the winner by knockout.
Well, there have got to be few things sweeter, Joe, than winning a rivalry fight like this in the UFC. And you can see the celebration is on, and why not? Huge result for him here tonight.
They hated Escobar. They hated Escobar. I'm still here. Dave East, talk that talk. Streets need that. NYC, LA, Chicago, Detroit, the whole world. Let's get it.
I had a basic plan, get out the projects and never look back. Could still smell the aroma from when my uncle was. Between homies, better yet brothers, that used to spend the night with each other. They moms with.